If you've ever considered adding a rotary product to your Haas mill, you're probably aware of the large variety of products we offer. From our HA5C all the way up to something like this HRT450 right here, we have nearly 40 four and five axis products for any Haas mill. And they can even be used on non-Haas mills as well. Because Haas has so many rotary products to choose from, it's important to understand how to connect your rotary table to your machine. If connected improperly or if the wrong parameters are loaded, you can run the risk of causing serious damage. Let's say, for example, that the tilt and rotary axes are accidentally reversed. If you're lucky, you'll notice that a commanded move is activating the wrong axis. For example, you command a tilt move and the rotary actually rotates. In this case, no harm done. But what if you accidentally connected the cables backwards and you commanded what you thought was a 360-degree rotary move, but you were actually commanding the tilt axis? You'd wrap the tilt axis cables up and most likely ruin them, as well as possibly damaging the machine itself in the process. Worst case, on some rotaries, having the cable reversed could result in the wrong current going to the rotary motors, potentially resulting in a fried motor. Luckily, properly installing a rotary is simple if you follow the correct process. So let's walk through it. First, let's talk about what the axes are called. Depending on where you look, you might see them referred to as fourth axis and fifth axis, or tilt and rotary, or for programming purposes, they may be referred to by their axis letter designation, like AB or AC, for example. These are different names that all mean the same things. The fourth axis is the same as tilt and is also the same as A axis. And fifth axis is the same as rotary axis and will also be either the B or C axis, depending on how the rotary is mounted. Check out these graphics so you can better understand. Okay, now that you know what they're called, you need to be 100% sure that you can connect the cables correctly. In this case, we're showing you a TRT100 on the machine, but the process holds true for any rotary product. On the side of the TRT100, you'll see the cables are identified as rotary and tilt. Connect the cable that is labeled tilt here on the rotary to the control cabinet connection labeled fourth axis. Follow along the cable from where it's labeled on the side of the rotary all the way to the plugs on the end to make sure you're connecting the tilt cable to the fourth axis receptacles. Now do the same for the cable labeled rotary and connect it to the cabinet connections labeled fifth axis. Now let's load parameters. Press settings on your keypad and navigate to rotary. In this case, we are installing a TRT100, so cursor down until you find TRT100. If you are installing a different rotary, you may notice a number of possibilities for each rotary. These are all designations for various models built over the years. If you aren't sure which to use, simply look at the ID plate attached to your rotary and load the matching parameter from the control screen. Okay, the rest of this is pretty simple, but we'll go through it step by step. The first one listed here is TRT100-P3-ROT. Highlight it, press enter, and you'll see that the control wants you to verify that the rotary platter is oriented upward and will be designated as the C axis. That's how we have it mounted and how we want it, so press enter to verify. Now we'll do the same thing for the tilt axis. Highlight TRT100-P3-TLT and press enter. Again, the control wants you to verify the orientation of the TRT on the table, and since that is correct, this will be designated the A axis for programming purposes. Now we press F3 to apply these rotary selections, and next, we'll cycle the power to complete the configuration process. So we've got the machine powered up again, and we need to zero return the axes to begin with. This gives us the perfect opportunity to test whether we've hooked the cables up correctly and to avoid any bad consequences if they're connected wrong. Press zero return, then the C key to select the C axis, and then press single. This will zero return only the C axis, and it does it slowly so the amperage going to the motor is low. This is a safe way to make sure you have the proper cable connection. In our case, we see the rotary C axis rotate as it should, and we know we're good to go. With that little check out of the way, we've successfully and safely connected our TRT100. Now we're ready to start using it. Thanks for watching.